Hi guys, Brandon Irdi from Tech Review by Irdi, and today we're going to replace an outer tie rod on this 2014 Dodge Charger. So stay tuned. First few things we're gonna do here is we're gonna make sure that we mark where our retainer nut is over here, which is the outside part of the tie rod. So we're gonna use a little bit of this here so we know exactly where we were before. And this is about 24 millimeters, this nut, so we're just gonna knock it real loose real quick. There we go. Bring that back up to position almost here, so we know exactly where it's at. All right, next we're gonna get this nut off here. Now this one's not being held on by any kind of retainer system. It's not a castle nut, obviously, so we're just gonna get that off with the regular old-fashioned way here. Now, using a 21 millimeter on this side here, I'm gonna go ahead and push this a little bit over to break a bar. There we go. So now that that's loose, we'll go ahead and continue to get that off. And go hit some blast on there real quick. That nut's old. All right, just about there. And there is our nut. Hot, under a lot of pressure. Wow, coming off is hard. Okay, now a lot of times these tools here will rip the boot depending on, you know, what you're doing. We can try to figure out about pounding it down or get the tie rod removal kit in here, which is what we're gonna do. There we go. All right, okay, now while we got this on here, I'm gonna go ahead and spin off the old tie rod. I'll get that off once we get it out of there. Just gonna spin it all the way out. Now remember, we haven't changed the distance of our locking nut on the inner tie rod, and we've also marked it. As you can see, even from previous alignments or whatever, they've marked the bottom with red. Hence why I went with a different color. I've seen it down there before. So we'll get this off. There we go. Make sure you've got the same distances from the center point to your new tie rod end. Obviously, this is a Moog, and this is the OEM here. We are in the same distance, so we're gonna basically put it in the same location. So let's go ahead and do that. We'll spin this one on the old inner tie rod. We won't be doing any bolting down or locking down just yet until we get this thing up inside. Get that going too as well. So let's use the new castle nut. See if this is the same size. It is. Tighten this up now. Now this outside nut here on the actual ball joint of the tie rod end, we're going to go down to 63 pounds pressure. The inner nut's going to be 55. The outside here is going to be 63. There we go. That was it. Now all we need to do is get this cotter pin in. Secure the castle nut in here with the cotter pin, which I've already done so. So I'm going to go ahead and pull these out. Twist them back. Okay, we should be good right there. Now, last but not least, I'm going to go ahead and twist up this bolt a little bit. Tighten it up. And that be it, folks. It's basically where we're set with the new tie rod. And again, it didn't take very long. Once you get this going, it's like a 10 to 15 minute job, depending on how much resistance and how much rust there's gonna be within everything, so. All right, well, last but not least, what we're gonna do is we're gonna put this grease fitting into the new tie rod in. Right. Now you have a choice. This is already pre-greased and filled up, and you can either go ahead and grease it up a little bit more and fill that boot up if you want to. It doesn't hurt anything. That's basically changing out the outer tie rod on this 2014 Charger. It works with pretty much all vehicles. So either your tie rod's pointing up or down or whatever it might be, usually there's a tool to get that tie rod ball joint out of there. You can also pound them out depending on the size of the vehicle or whatnot. But otherwise, you saw how quick and easy it was. The actual job only took about 15 minutes tops. With the power of editing, obviously you can see me running back and forth to get a couple tools here and there because I don't place them all out here. But otherwise than that, thanks for watching Tech Review by Irdi. It was a quick and easy fix today, just doing this tie rod. We're pretty close to the old alignment. You might still have to get an alignment done, especially if you change out the inners as well, or both sides. Thanks for watching this episode of Tech Review by Irdi, Cars and Go Fast, and we'll catch you next time, so there'll be more videos. See you later. Thanks.
Bye.
7654321.
You'll never have the sacred stone.
Oh, this you crazy mother...